Hi everyone, I'm Zach Reinhardt, here with episode, I think, 11 of the EP Wrap-Up. The EP Wrap-Up is an irregular series I do whenever I have a few EPs that I've been listening to, and I want to recommend your way. Before I get into the EPs, though, I do want to talk briefly about the fact that I am going to Japan in late November. I'm heading there for the 22nd. Through to the 29th, staying for a week. And I just want to know what kind of content you guys want. I'm definitely going to be seeing some shows and meeting some people that I only know through like Twitter and stuff while I'm over there. But what kind of videos do you guys want? I'm obviously not going to just film concerts and upload them on here, but I could maybe get some clips and talk about some of the bands. I could maybe try to get some interviews lined up with somebody, or I could just vlog. I don't know. Leave any suggestions you have in the comments. I'm open to really anything. And let's get into the EPs this week. Starting us off this week, we have the new mini album from P-iPLE, and it's called, brace yourself, Do-do-do, A Silly Travel by Bicycle. Bicycle. P-iPLE is a hardcore punk band from Tokyo, Japan, and they were on the Throw Away Your CDs, Go Out to a Show compilation record that I reviewed very recently, and they had a really solid, kind of blistering, energetic, hardcore punk track that was short but very sweet. That was similarly in-your-face, loud, and noisy, and I quickly figured out that P-iPLE is a band that is very much up my alley. And I picked up this mini-album, and I have been listening to it a lot lately. This thing is filled with punchy, energetic drums, fat bass tones, brittle, fuzzy guitars, shouted vocals, and tons of energy, all wrapped up in some really nice production and a really consistent track listing. There's just a lot of good, old-fashioned, punky fun on this record, with the upbeat Matic Askar, the somewhat poppy Starbucks Curse, and the dense, noisy, and chaotic DAM, the closer. There's also just some really tight, fun grooves on here, like on the tracks Do It Guys and Dead in Her Tracks. This is a pretty short whirlwind of a record at only 15 minutes for 7 tracks. But every track on here is pretty solid, and it's not any great reinvention of punk by any means, but it is punk done really sincerely and with a lot of heart, and I can really get into a record like this. Then, shifting gears entirely, we're going to talk about the new P-iPLE's EP, Dream, or D-R-E-A-M, as it is abbreviated. P-iPLE's is a kind of nocturnal, smooth, dancey pop band from Tokyo, and this is their second EP, and they also had a record that came out late last year. This is, however, my first run-in with them, as I saw some people hyping up some of their stuff last year, but I never really looked into it until I saw this new EP come out, and I figured I'd give it a shot. And while I'm not in love with everything on here, there are definitely some pretty slick, well-done, catchy pop tracks on here. The single to this EP, Shooting Star, is a good example of that, with its smooth synth groove, kind of 80s throwback vibe, and almost Justin Timberlake-esque vocals, with a very catchy chorus. I find this song to be really infectious and fun to listen to. I also really like the track Lying, which has a kind of sleepy tone to it that took a little bit to grow on me, but when it did, I finally found that this song has just a really nice groove to it, a kind of sensual vibe, and some really nice, slick guitar solos, even if I'm not in love with the vocals on this track. Unfortunately, not all the tracks on this EP are slick, well-performed pop songs, as we see on the track Motion, M-O-T-N. This song features just a really generic kind of Chicago house, deep house groove, and some really lackluster vocals, and really nothing particularly memorable about it, except for the bridge, which takes a little bit of a turn towards the direction of future funk, which is a bit of an improvement, but still ultimately doesn't save the song from being one of the more forgettable tracks on the track listing. But overall, this thing is fairly solid, but I'm not confident P-iPLE could keep me entertained for the length of a full record. But if you're looking for some clean, smooth, somewhat nocturnal pop songs that are dancey and well-performed, this is definitely a band worth checking out. I'm not thrilled about all of their songs, but there's definitely some real gems in here. And finally this week, we have the new Tropical Death EP, Modern Maze. Tropical Death is a four-piece punk and post-punk band with a bit of a pop edge and maybe a dash of post-hardcore thrown in there. I really loved their last EP, Thunder Island, that came out last year. It was one of my favorite EPs of last year, and it was upbeat, it was punky, it was in your face, but it was also accessible and fairly easy to listen to, and had a little bit of math thrown in there for good measure that I really appreciated. And on this new EP, Tropical Death hasn't changed up their formula hugely, but is incorporating a bit more pop-punk elements into their songs. The title track, Modern Maze, is a good example of this. It starts out with some fairly typical pop-punk guitars, a upbeat rhythm section that reminds me a little bit of the band Dayglow, and some kind of melancholy, clean vocals from lead singer Eugene Rosen. This track is kind of flanked on either end by this pop-punk section, but in the middle we get this big, evolving, kind of constantly moving and changing jam section that I find really compelling. The tones of all the instruments sound really great, and this thing is really slickly performed. Everything is done really well, and is very tight. I really love the tracks Tribal and So Wet, that are both very energetic, upbeat, and in-your-face, but also fairly easy to listen to and accessible, despite the fact that they use a fair amount of, like, dissonance within their harmony that I think is really well used and well placed and is actually very tasteful. These songs really straddle the line between punk aggression and pop accessibility, and I think they walk that line really deftly, and these songs are very compelling as a result. I'm honestly not a huge fan of Eugene's clean vocals on this record. I think they're all right, but he's fairly mediocre overall. But the kind of shouted vocals that were all over their last EP are definitely on this EP as well, and I think they're very energetic and put a lot of presence into the song. And overall, the performances are really great on this thing. Everything's really well written as well, and the production is clean and clear and punchy, but not so clean to the point where it loses any of the power and energy of the band. I think this thing is a really solid EP, and I think all of these are pretty solid EPs, and you can check them out. Links in the description as usual, where you can go give these things a listen. And that's it for the EP wrap-up this week. Quick reminder, let me know in the comments what kind of content you want out of my trip to Japan coming up next month. And I'll see you guys next week for another review. Peace.